But I'm going to use this GPS this morning. Get your hand, your Bibles in your hand, praise God. Get it in your, I promise you today, if you don't have your Bible, get by somebody that has a Bible. Hallelujah. If I could get two ushers, praise God, I need somebody to pass these tissues. I promise I'm going to replace them. Each one of us get a tissue. I promise you. See, sometimes I love how God uses me, praise God. When he used me, it'd be so simple, you can't err. Baby can't err, praise God. He used the simple things. Simple. Because we got evangelists in the house. We got pastors in the house. We got prophets in the house. Hallelujah. But God want to free us from all this unnecessary baggage. And I'm going to tell you, when I first got, I didn't mind paying the first, because, well, I ain't have no choice. She said, for the first bag. Now, then you're talking about bearing the set. This is for the first bag. The first bag cost me as much as a ticket did.
Hallelujah.
I ain't have no choice. I knew I was on assignment. I'm like, okay, God. I had exactly what they was asking for. I'm like, I can't miss this plane because there's only one that's leaving. I said, okay, God, if it's you, God, you make a way. I pulled out my money, paid for the bags. I'm like, oh, God, now I can't get no soda water, no cookies, no chips on. Now you got to even pay for the pretzels and the soda. And my husband, oh, how much I love a Coke. So now I'm on the plane angry because they not giving no free Cokes away no more. No peanuts, no pretzels. And if you're going to buy something, you better buy it in the airport. When I get to my mom, it's like a shopping mall in my mom's house. And I'm like, oh, man. Oh, gee, what am I going to do? I do my assignment. My mom would say, well, take this in. You can have this in. You can take this. And that's when I got this message, y'all. I said, Mama, as much as I want to take this, jewelry, shoes, dresses, oh, God, food, I say, Mama, I can't. I can't take it. I can't take it on the plane. I can't take it. They even threw away my grapes, y'all. Oh, I'm delivered. I said, well, Mama, I can't take it. She said, well, you and Aaron, y'all come down, y'all drive down, y'all take it. But I wanted it right then. She has some nice stuff, wow. But I couldn't take it. When I got on the plane, praise God, hallelujah, I sat by our lady, praise God, and she was just back and forth. I could tell that I have met some wonderful people on my journey. She was just going back and forth. I'm like, well, what's wrong with her? I'm like, well, then another gentleman came in, and we was like, so when the gentleman left, and I say, you're gonna be all right. She just guzzling down them little shot bottom. I'm like, oh, look. I'm like, you're gonna be all right? And I said, you're really gonna be all right, but you know, you kind of killing them, you know? She said, well, yeah, I'm going to meet so and so and so. And I met him on the line. He's like, you what? I said, don't do that no more. She said, but I never knew that was the first time I ever met the lady. And she said, would you pray that everything go well? And I said, you know what? First of all, don't ever do that again. But I'm going to cover you. I'm going to pray that God covers you because you're here. And when you meet him, She said, well, would you go with me? I'm like, oh, because I had somebody that was picking me up. And I said, well, yeah. I said, ooh, this lady is serious. So she was right on my toes. Well, I would have my little luggage going down the aisle, and she was right on my toes. I said, look, I said, Carol, if you see my finger up, he all right. But if you see my finger go down, you get back on that plane. Don't you ask nobody. You get back on that plane. So we went up to the guy. She said, this my pastor. The man's eyes got that big. She said, this my pastor. He's like, well, I better watch my words. And I'm like, yes, you better watch your words, because if I hear whiff of anything that's not right about you, I'm coming at you. So they got, and they went on about their ways. And anyway, I just heard, Pastor Gladys. Pastor, I even told her I was even a pastor. I don't think I even told her what my name was. But anyway, she came by, and she took my hand, thank you, and she gave me a $50 bill. I'm like, I want to say, well, no. But that was the blessing. That was the blessing. Now, remember what I said earlier? When you're on assignment, wow. And I said, well, thank you, God. Look at God. Praise God. I thank God. But I just want to stop by and share a couple of things. Sometimes the enemy have you or remind you of old past hurts, old past wounds, unsuccessful marriages, children acting cuckoo for Cocoa Pop. Hallelujah. Some of us carry around things when we was 2 years old. And you go to the class reunion, I remember such and such and such. I remember when you used to date my boyfriend. Are you serious? Those are the things, those are the extra baggage that we carry around in our lives. And let me tell you, one thing about church hurt, a lot of people are sitting in church with church hurt, old past church hurt. Hallelujah. Things that you cannot do anything about, drop it, leave it, and let it go. Jobs that God has closed the door on you, drop it, leave it, and let it go.
Let it go. Let it go. That's it. Let it go.
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 Hallelujah.
Let it go.
Childhood hurts. My mama molested me. My daddy molested me. My uncle molested me. God said, drop it. Leave it and let it go.
That's it.
Because he's bringing us to a place in him this day. The reason why you can't clap your hands, stomp your feet, sing your song, preach the word, because you carrying around baggage. Drop it. Leave it. And let it go. Because what I remember what I just told you on this plane is taking off.
Well, beautiful.
And some of us are going to get left behind. Because you got so much baggage. They don't stop you at the gate. Some of our minds are so corrupt. In church, the pastor bringing the word, especially these phones, praise God. This one texting me in church, where you at? What you mean, where Drop it. Leave it. And let it go. Hallelujah. Let it go. Let it go. Little things. She sung my song. I can sing it better than her. I was going to sing that song. And now you're rolling your eyes. Discuss it.
Nope. Yep.
Nope. Drop it. Leave it. And let it go. Yes. 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 Because if you don't forgive them, it didn't say the pastor wasn't going to forgive you. Forgive your transgression. That means your sin, your secret sin, the ones that's in the closet that don't nobody know. Now you see why I had to come down? Do I have to go up there?
No.
I came down here. Drop it. Our churches is not filled, praise God, because of you. You. They stand to come and sit by you, praise God, because they scared a man. My mama, see that name? Seat. Drop it. Leave it. I ain't seen nobody break it up. Lord, have I not said something that ain't touched nobody yet? Y'all gonna make me preach hard, right? Yeah.
Go ahead, Ryan. That's good.
Drop it. Leave it. Let it go. Some of us has habits.
Go ahead, brother. Go ahead.
Some of us has habits. Thank you, brother. I love him for real.
That's it.
He cannot do anything illegal to you. Cigarettes. He got to tell you. May cause cancer. Harmful to your health. He got to tell you. Still carrying it around if you're not delivered.
When King David had Uriah killed,
Well, Ahithophel was King David's wife, his grandfather. Okay, his grandfather was king. Ahithophel was next to David. He was his advisor. So you couldn't get no better than being the pastor's aide or whatever. You know, you couldn't get no better than that. But he was his advisor. But then again, when King David's son rose up against King David, Ahithophel started siding with King David's son. Now, what a thing to do. And what happened in that story, what blessed me in that story, that is happening today, when he did that, and I thought he was the only one that hung himself. I really thought, Judah was the only one that hung himself, but Ahithophel hung himself. He went out, he was feeling so heavy, had so much baggage carried all around, because he had did David so wrong, because when he married King David's wife, Delilah. King David's wife, Delilah. Well, when he married him, Ahithophel felt so guilty about it, he went and hung himself. Can you imagine, praise God, because you didn't forgive that person? That baggage can kill you. It can cause all type of stuff in your family to happen. Some of the crazy stuff that's happening in your lives is because of you carrying around excess baggage. Bye-bye drinking. Bye-bye smoking. Because you cross over here, you might get saved, you might get delivered, you might get set free. Sometimes, praise God, you got to rebuke that thing and say, "Oh, devil, I don't care what you say. My God says, if I delight myself in Him, He'll give me the desires of my heart. I don't need no high blood pressure, because it's extra baggage. It's extra baggage. Diabetes is extra baggage. Hallelujah, unforgiveness is extra baggage." Yes. 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 It's extra baggage. Hallelujah. My God says yes. I know a God that sits high and low.
Joy of the Lord is your strength. I was here when Antoine Jasmine had ministered to you. He was trying to encourage you then, because you was going through. And that same word that he spoke back then, that was back in April, when that was the last time I was here. That same word is for you. You do have a call on your life, and I see it on you. But God, what he's trying to do is build you. He's trying to mold you. Because it's about going through. We as ministers, we go through. You're going to go through some things. You're going to go through some times. I don't know if I can do it. I don't know if I can make it. Child of God, be encouraged. Hold on. Your blessing is on the way. God got them. He just using them. He just using them to make you.
Come on now.
That's my word for you. The same word that Antoine Jasper spoke to you is still for today. I'm in agreement with him in the spirit. In the name of Jesus, touch her right now. Thank you, Lord, for moving right now. Thank you, Lord, for breaking the shackles right now. Thank you, Lord, for loosening up. Woman, thou art loosed in the name of Jesus. And loosen the call, the prophetic call on your life. In the name of Jesus. God said, I've been showing you things. You even had some dreams. I'm just going with God here. I don't know nothing. Thank you, Lord. But it's going to work out for you in your favor. In Jesus' name. Watch God move. Now I'm a football player now. I'm a linebacker. When Jesus saw this man under demonic influence, he spoke to that man. He had chains on him, he had nothing on. But Jesus spoke a word to him. That devil had to go. That man been bound for so long. That's all he do, scare people off. Because they didn't know what to do with him. But Jesus, the type of person that he was, if you needed help, he helped you through it.
I feel it.
Just like with the woman. They wanted to stone her. But you know what Jesus did? He wrote. Can't nobody throw no stones at you. Why? Because Jesus is on your side. We all need deliverance. We all go through. My word for you, hold on. Be encouraged. Just stand. See the salvation of the Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And I rebuke any demonic influence right now. Be gone back to the pits of hell from whence it came. God is going to restore your joy. Hey, in the name of Jesus. I feel some stuff breaking this morning. Woo! Solomon's Temple, y'all working me this morning. Woo! But I thank God for it. Hey, in the name of Jesus, I'm praying for your ears. You stay to the sound doctrine of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, your future is looking better. And it started right now. In Jesus' name, woman be thou made whole. Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Amen. Be encouraged. I speak Isaiah 53 and 5. By his stripes, this happened way before he even got on the cross. Every whipping that he took, every blood that was shed, he took it for you. 39 stripes. At that which is spoken to me, you are healed. So praise him for your healing right now. He bore it all on the cross for you. So you might as well praise him right now. I'm hearing God say, no more worry. No more worry. Don't worry. I got this. I got this. I got this. This mine, said the Lord. It's mine. It's mine. Hey, in the name of Jesus, and we decree and declare right now, it's done right now, in Jesus' name. Hey. I'm going to let God deal with you. God dealing with you. What's on your mind? What's on your mind? We're going to Isaiah 53 and 5, okay? In the name of Jesus, by his stripes, you are healed. Isaiah 55 and 11, his word will not return back void unto him. In the name of Jesus, so I'm speaking the word to your spirit man right now. That it is healed. You are healed. Even your family is healed right now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for doing it right now. I pray for your back. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for doing it right now. Hey, touch my brother right now. Touch my brother. Yes, God. Supply every need. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Jesus' name. Amen. Isaiah 53 and 5. By your stripes you are healed. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I take all this off of you, all that stress. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord. Be thou made whole right now in your spirit and your mind. In the name of Jesus, I command it all to dry up right now. Yes, God. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord. Lord, just like you spoke to that fig tree, and it dried up and it withered. But that's what we're doing here right now concerning his situation. Thank you, Lord, for the spoken word. That it is done right now. In Jesus' name we pray.